Subscribe Smartick Magic's channel and hit the bell icon beside it, and on the bell icon select all to watch latest tech videos before anyone else. Hello friends, myself Dushan Kumar Dash. Once again, welcome back to my YouTube channel Smart Tech Magics. Let's start with today's tech news, and this is the 20th episode of it. So let's begin. Starting with the first news is coming from Oppo, Vivo, Xiaomi, Huawei Global Developer Service Alliance. Oppo, Vivo, Xiaomi and Huawei are joining forces to create a platform known as Global Developer Service Alliance for developers outside China to upload apps onto all of their app stores simultaneously to challenge the dominance of Google Play Store. This platform aims to make it easier for app or game developers to market their apps in overseas markets. Sources said that the Global Developer Service Alliance was initially aiming to launch in March, but at present it is not clear due to the recent coronavirus outbreak. A prototype website says that the platform will initially cover 9 regions including India, Indonesia and Russia. By forming this alliance, each company will be looking to support the others' advantages in different regions, with Xiaomi's strong user base in India, Oppo and Vivo in Southeast Asia, and Huawei in Europe. The next news is regarding the Boeing Space Taxi mission failure and its recovery. On Thursday, a NASA safety review panel said that the agency examined Boeing's software verification process before letting it fly humans to space. Panel member Paul Hill said that the newly revealed software bug, which Boeing said was fixed while the CST-100 Starliner was still in orbit, could have led to erroneous thruster firings that could have resulted in a catastrophic spacecraft failure. Boeing and NASA officials had zeroed in on an unrelated glitch with a spacecraft automated timer hours after the spacecraft failed to reach the intended orbit 30 minutes into the flight. The timer malfunction forced the craft to drop its meeting with the International Space Station and return to Earth a week early. Boeing and SpaceX company are building separate space taxis to ferry astronauts to the space station under NASA's effort to revive its human space flight mission. The next news is regarding the extreme durability failure of Moto Razr. Recently, Mac Winback retweeted a video showing how half of the screen of Moto Razr is completely destroyed. You can see the clip. Guys, this was nothing unexpected, cause a week ago he uploaded a video on Twitter which showed how a cracking sound is generated when the phone is folded and unfolded. You can see the clip. This sound shows that a very cheap quality material was used to make this device. Now guys, just think. First of all, the processor is extremely weak for a $1,500 smartphone. Next of all, it's having only a single camera, and now we can see the durability is extremely pathetic. Guys, what are your thoughts regarding this device? Please comment down below. The next news is coming from Google Maps. Google Maps celebrated its 15th birthday with a makeover new features. Google Maps on Thursday launched a redesign that prominently solicits user reviews and photos of places they visit, seeking to grow its data in a field led by local search apps such as Zomato, TripAdvisor and Yelp. According to Google, more than 1 billion people now turn to Google Maps to see and explore the world. The new Google Maps icon is based on a key part of the tool since the very beginning, the pin, and represents the shift it has made from getting people to the destination to also helping them discover new places and experiences. Google last year introduced crowdedness prediction to help users see how crowded their bus, train or subway is likely to be based on past rides. The new features will allow people to check in advance if the temperature is considered by past riders as on colder or warmer side. In regions where transit systems have designated women sections or carriages, the new update will help surface this information along with whether other passengers abide by it. This update will start rolling out globally in March, although availability may vary by region. Google Maps is focusing on improving people's experiences. It has mapped more than 220 countries and surfaced information for about 200 million places and businesses. Google has invested billions of dollars from its search ads business to digitally map the world, drawing 1 million users each month to its free navigation app. The next news is regarding the hackers on various social media accounts. Facebook accounts on Twitter, Instagram hacked via third-party platform. The hackers posted with a statement, "Hi, we are our mind. Well, even Facebook is hackable, but at least their security is better than Twitter." The account of Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey was hacked in August, allowing an unauthorized person to send public tweets, including racial slurs and curse words, to his 4 million followers before Twitter secured it. As per the CNET reports, Twitter declined to name the third-party platform, but a screenshot of tweets shows that the post came from a social media management tool, Khoros. The hacker group OurMind hijacked the past Twitter accounts of more than a dozen NFL teams in January before the Super Bowl. The same group has also compromised Twitter accounts of Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg, Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey, and Google CEO Sundar Pichai. The group has been active since 2016 and is believed to consist of several teenagers. Now guys, going through all this news, it seems that hacking is now simply a child's play, which a hacker can easily do. So today's tech news ends here. If you like this tech news, then please hit the like button. Like target is only 50. Please help me to complete my target. And if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe it and tap the bell icon beside it. And on the bell icon, select all to watch my latest videos before anyone else. So once again, thanks for watching. See you soon in my next video. Until then, goodbye. We are heroes tonight. We will fly above the sky.